7-0.
One matchup to watch. Gabby Williams is checking Arike Ogunbowale, who just touched the ball for the first time. Vastly improved numbers from a season ago. Better outside jump shot for her.
Boy, she's hitting 56% beyond the three-point line. And a quick strike inside for Turner.
And one of the reasons the Irish have been successful, we showed you 7-7 over the last 14. The Irish is one team in the country that can score to the level that Connecticut can score. You've got to be able to put a number up.
UConn number one without the trio of Stewart, Jefferson, and Tuck anymore. Here's Chong. Fires that one back. Samuelson's first three and on target.
They do it a little more by committee, and Collier's been terrific.
And a foul with 12 seconds on the shot clock. And that will send Williams to the line, where she makes 64%.
Oh, I'd rather have seen a play on, to be perfectly. The drive, defense is not in great position necessarily. And sometimes those can be play-ons to me.
Ogunbowale going one-on-one. Flips it up, but it's in and out. Boy, that was in the cylinder.
Oh, she's a big-time difficult check. There's not a phase of the game now because she's out of that three-point shot there that she cannot score from.
The season started by going 5 for 5 beyond the three-point line in the opener, and that's up and in by Collier.
This comes from the offensive player or the defensive player. That's a major point of emphasis.
Notre Dame, four consecutive empty trips, and a quick strike down low for William. Looking for Collier again, going up against Turner. On the drive, Nurse out of the double team. Great ball movement. Here's Samuelson. Can't connect from three. Collier there to scoop that up, and she'll take the hit. He's 73% at the line and hits the first. Let's go to Holly.
Point guard, she just doesn't have the experience, so an early foul on Allen is a big deal.
Well, Marina Mabry is...
Here comes Allen now, already with 1,000 points in her outstanding career. Nice dish underneath for Westfeld, and she connects.
Lindsay Allen, as Muppet calls her, the soul of our team. You're talking about an experienced point guard who understands the system, understands who to get the ball to and when. Really good job getting into their tempo game and making decisions.
Notre Dame had missed 5 in a row. Here's Williams. Gave up the dribble, back for Chong. Shot clock down to 7. She finds a lane, flips it up. Rebound tip controlled, and it's Chong to come down with it. Here's Williams. Got it.
Yeah. Best of Turner. I think she needs more repetition and more time after that shoulder surgery that kept her out for 4 months.
Westbell with a nice move underneath. Shot to make it to age. Williams again. She's had a hot hand here early. Here's 6 points. That was her first miss. Ogunbowale straight on. Got that one. Maybe that'll get her started.
Yeah.
Williams coming in at 10.7 rebounds a game. Get the feeling she can do more than that. Nearly taken away by the Irish. Downstairs for Williams. Can't bank it in. Collier again, and that one will spin out. Taken away and laid right back up and in by Williams. She's been relentless.
From an Irish team that we're accustomed to being very patterned.
Underneath, Samuelson will get 2.
It's coming easy for Connecticut. That's a nice little strong side cut by Katie Lou, who comes at you with good size.
6'3". And back with a vengeance after she was forced to miss the national championship game because of injury in the spring. Ogunbowale gets her own shot, sticks it.
And that's with size in her face and a hand in contest. Now, this kid has just got all the swag in the world on the offensive end of the floor.
Averaging 18 coming in. Collier, you're talking about too easy. So Collier, Ogunbowale again, that three-pointer got a good look. It comes out high. Back for Allen. Triple team. She'll drive it anyway. And lay it in.
Now she has not had...
On a 5-7. Ogunbowale. Nifty give for Allen for two.
How pretty.
UConn with three consecutive turnovers. The only another one there is Williams got it off to Samuelson, and she sticks it.
It's amazing to me the different levels of play you can get from both of these teams. And I know it's early, but I think our expectations for both of them is that they're going to play at a high level no matter what. Players in different roles trying to accept more responsibility. This is what you're going to get.
Jump shot didn't touch anything there from Bowley. On the run. Look at Williams beat everybody to the other end.
Got to tune in to LaChina's podcast.
UConn with Crystal Dangerfield in the game. Little 5'5 freshman is Williams, who's had the hot hand, knocking in two more. Off to an excellent start here tonight. And UConn leading at 25-14. It's their biggest lead. Turner with a touch. Turns and fires and got it. Notre Dame 0-for-4 from three-point land. Here's Allen. Like she was listening to you.
Yeah, and just a
shot down to three. Jump shot in there. And Todd Williams didn't touch a thing. Geary stole it away. Here's Young to knock it in. And a foul as well, right along the baseline.
Placed, and then you don't see it, but Allen completes the play.
Turner doubled up, gets it out for Young. She hits it. A three.
To my house with that.
Seven on the shot clock. There goes Butler. She gives it away to Chong and lays it in on a blocking foul as well at the line. And a three-point play. Nelson with the hook. Yes.
It's good to see a frustration. But I'll tell you what, she came prepared to play. Does she have another one? No.
Olsen with the rebound. The Irish want to attack. Here comes Allen. Into the paint. The whistle. And Butler there for the rebound. Nurse. She'll lay it in.
We've seen.
Get it to go. Ogunbowale kind of split two defenders. To the baseline. Yes!
She's got
the lead. They want Turner. Can't get that one to fall. She wins it back. Here's Johnson coming off the bench for the three. On the line for UConn tonight. Here's Allen. And this batted to Turner is there to clean it up, but can't hit. And another whistle. A lot of fouls here in the first half.
Do you see what
Associated Press All-America team, and since the first. At the PA.
Wow, Warriors Clippers, could that be a preview of the Western Conference Finals? And
at midcourt with a minute 48 to go here in the second. All time, they are 34-11 against Notre Dame. Samuelson wants it. Nothing falling right now. Williams back out and tipped out of play by Mabry.
Half second jumper.
Now the freshman, Dangerfield. It could be very, very explosive. Williams again. Lost the dribble. Out of play off Notre Dame. Barnes plays about 21 minutes a game. Sanderson blocked out of the sky. That was Young. John goes down for it. Another tie-up. It'll stay on this end on the possession arrow.
It was up nine when Nafisa Collier went out. And now they're down four, and they get to within two.
And Samuelson for the bucket. Stolen away by Samuelson. Young right behind her, but she will lay it in.
Yeah, just great anticipation. You know that only a two-second differential, but I believe that like this, maybe with an opportunity just for an offensive rebound, but keep the Irish from getting a good look when they get it back.
John with it. Williams looking inside, up in there. On the drive, can't get it to go. And the heave will be well short. That's how the first half comes to an end.
Going to give him spot minutes on the interior. Dangerfield has had an up and down start to the season, as you might expect a freshman to do.
Collier back in there to start the second half. And a nice move, quick step there for two.
Yeah, listen.
Williams looking inside, nothing there. Shot clock down to 9. He's Dangerfield, way downtown. They barely nicked the iron. And now back to the speedy Allen. Young, deflected. Once again, it's Williams. She's had a terrific defensive game. Freshman with a nice bounce feed, and Collier connects.
Yeah, it's amazing how much easier a pass is if you take the appropriate angle. And listen, some of that is inborn to me for Dangerfield. You play the point guard from the time you're a little kid, your feel for the game is drastically different.
Once again, guess who? It's Williams with the theft. Back up for Nurse, and she'll lay it in.
I'll tell you this, they're going to get a timeout from Muffet.
A very personal connection, but I just like to thank my friend Doris Burke. She's the one that actually thought to call the V Foundation and get me connected. I say everybody who's watching this game, even if you only donated $1, we would make a huge impact to this great research that's happening to save people's lives.
Young with the theft, and Irish come away with this with under 4 minutes to go here in the third. Johnson. Espo giving it back to the All-American candidate, Lindsey Allen. On the attack. Up and in for two.
You see what I mean as a scorer, how capable.
Two-pointer. Johnson can't drain the three. Turner with a big rebound. Turner with 6-3. Allen. Westbell gets a good look. Allen. Shot clock down to 12. Turner with a bounce feed. Oh, great strike.
See, Connecticut does a lot of switching across the board. And really great recognition in a high-low with the two post players. Westbell just beat Connecticut to the spot. Got great post-up position.
Williams, Collier on the roll, and she'll hit it.
What a terrific pass.
1 minute here in the third.
We got a bad matchup. And Lindsey Allen recognizes it. Dangerfield checking Westbell, but shot clock running down.
And a 4 in the whistle. That's UNLV. First meeting between those two since the Blue Devils beat the Runnin' Rebs in the 1991 Final Four.
Consider again when conference play rolls around.
No, they just own it. And Allen makes another one.
Just got win number 600, so congrats to Coach Self. But watch out for Baylor. They are rising right now, or as the kids say, trending. Baylor not going to go away so easily in the Big 12 this season.
As the kids say. Baylor with a big win in Atlanta. Samuelson lays it in.
That's a big-time shot and a big-time move right there. You know, you sell out on her as a three-point shooter. I do think if you get a smaller defender up underneath her and make her a playmaker off the dribble, that's harder. But you put a big on her, she's not afraid to go to the deck.
Samuelson's first points in that half, and that one picked off by Williams. On the attack, Shalada.
This kid's been dynamite. Holly opened the show talking about being special with your effort. Gabby Williams has...
Williams. Collier. Allen interrupted that, and a whistle, a 5-10.
Frustrating finish to the quarter, right? The Irish got the crowd back involved.
The second left here in the third, nails it. So it's good for Turner, now back up top here.
Look at Kia Nurse. Just ready to give some assistance, get out and challenge. Nurse doing her job defensively. Look at that. Dropping in.
Allen trying to spin. Tough shot. Got it.
That's big time.
You could be strong with the ball here to end this game.
Good job by Gabby Williams to make the quick switch again. Connecticut's communication with all of these switches so crucial.
Here's Young over the top. Nice pass. Ogunbowale with a second effort and draws the foul.
Is that going to be on Kari?
On that one. Maybe. Ogunbowale with an averaging 18.
I mean, both of these teams are going to look so drastically different.
Samuelson wants to go hard, flipped it up there and draws the whistle. 82% at the line. Here's Holly.
It's been different for you, and she said, you know, they didn't need me to be the go-to player last year. Of course, they have Brianna.
Samuelson. Williams, who's had such an impressive night. Here's Dangerfield with a left hand and two.
I tell you, the kid, it's not been a vintage night. It's not been what she did against Baylor, but she's fearless regardless of the circumstance.
And 19 against Baylor.
This is a tough matchup with a Gumbawale on her posting up.
There's almost a steal. Great dish there. Turner will finish it.
Well, how good is Lindsay Allen? How about that for execution?
Outstanding. Yeah, off the inbound.
That's nice.
That would have been a really big make for the Huskies. Ogunbowale off the back of the iron. She's hitting 56% from the three-point line. Going up on the six-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. Turner. West Bell wants to go one-on-one. Turner got to it and hit it.
Well, she's been...
Now Dangerfield getting some very big minutes here at Notre Dame.
He's chosen to finish with her quite often.
Shot clock down to 13. Nurse in the corner.
Dangerous pass.
Collier working on Turner. What a move that was.
Yeah, she has just got it.
Minutes to play here in South Bend. Nurse, tough drive, and draws another foul. And she will be at the line to shoot a pair.
I also think across the lower levels of basketball in the country, it has to happen. If our basketball at the youth is going to, you know, help.
UConn 11 for 11 at the foul line. Allen for Turner.
Nice.
That's tough to stop. Points in this quarter. Went for the block. Samuelson to miss. Right back up. Williams not there for her. And a kick out.
Oh, she has got just big time leaping ability. Unbelievable timing.
Dangerfield. Here's Gabby Williams, the junior from Nevada. Has really come up big here tonight. Shot clock down to 7 and a strike.
This is just delivered.
And 7 out of 9 shooting. Turner again. She may touch it every time down the floor here. Holly, you were listening to Muffet McGraw's huddle.
That's right. They want to focus on driving the basketball to the huddle. They said when we drive it, we get good touches. We are making progress.
Samuelson and one. She'll be at the line. Outstanding play.
They're spacing them. They get her isolated at that right elbow and let her go one on.
Allen. Lot of contact. And she'll be at the line if there's tonight. And can't hit the first. UNLV, I'll be there if my voice comes back.
Yes, yes, you get a little bit of a well out. Maybe.
150. Yeah. I think you're right. At the line. She hits it anyway. This is the biggest.
Oh, make two free throws. She is in pain. That is
7 to 54. Under 2 to go. Ogunbowale with a miss. Turner tips it up and in.
This kid came in, I want you to understand, 12 to 15 foot shots, then she can help us. I'll tell you what, you give that, and folks, their ceiling is high, because if you saw what they, Doug is always, you know, has a good offensive mojo about his group, gives him a ton of freedom.
And those foul shots keep on.
And I'll tell you this, he scheduled everybody. You know, you played a number of some toughness right now.
And a three-pointer cuts the cords for
about it.
And showing that this season for sure.
I said today on Mike and Mike, I don't know whether it's the aura or the Oriema. And I don't know how you quantify Gino's impact on this group. I don't know that there's a point total you can put on it, but there's no question his effect is real.
And what an effect. As UConn comes to South Bend and knocks off Notre Dame 72-61. That is 83 consecutive wins. Today, Collier connects.
Yeah, it's amazing how much easier a pass is if you take the appropriate angle. And listen, some of that is inborn to me for Dangerfield. You play the point guard from the time you're a little kid, your feel for the game is drastically different.
Once again, guess who? It's Williams with the theft. Back up for Nurse, and she'll lay it in.
I'll tell you this, they're going to get a timeout from Muffet.
A very personal connection, but I just like to thank my friend Doris Burke. She's the one that actually thought to call the V Foundation and get me connected. Everybody who's watching this game, even if you only donated $1, we would make a huge impact to this great research that's happening with safety.
Young with the theft, and Irish come away with this with under 4 minutes to go here in the third. Johnson. Westbrook giving it back to the All-American candidate, Lindsey Allen. On the attack. Up and in for two.
You see what I mean as a scorer, how capable.
Pointer. Johnson can't drain the three. Turner with a big rebound. Turner with 6-3. Allen. Westbell gets a good look. Allen. Shot clock down to 12. Turner with a bounce feed. Oh, great strike.
See, Connecticut does a lot of switching across the board. And really great recognition in a high-low with the two post players. Westbell just beat Connecticut to the spot. Got great post-up position.
Williams. Collier on the roll, and she'll hit it.
What a terrific pass.
1 minute here in the third.
Well, you got a bad matchup. And Lindsey Allen recognizes it. Dangerfield checking Westbell, but shot clock running down.
And a four in the whistle. That's UNLV. First meeting between those two since the Blue Devils beat the Runnin' Rebs in the 1991 Final Four.
Consider again when conference play rolls around.
No, they just own it. And Allen makes another one.
Just got win number 600, so congrats to Coach Self. But watch out for Baylor. They are rising right now, or as the kids say, trending. Baylor not going to go away so easily in the Big 12 this season.
As the kids say. Baylor with a big win in Atlanta. Samuelson lays it in.
That's a big-time shot and a big-time move right there. Well, you sell out on her as a three-point shooter. I do think if you get a smaller defender up underneath her and make her a playmaker off the dribble, that's harder. But you put a big on her, she's not afraid to go to the deck.
Samuelson's first points in that half, and that one picked off by Williams. On the attack, Shalada.
This kid's been dynamite. Holly opened the show talking about being special with your effort. Gabby Williams has...
Williams. Collier. Allen interrupted that, and a whistle of 5 10.
But I'll tell you what, she came prepared to play. Does she have another one? No.
Olsen with the rebound. The Irish want to attack. Here comes Allen. Into the paint. The whistle. And Butler there for the rebound. Nurse. She'll lay it in.
We've seen.
Get it to go. Remember, Wally kind of split two defenders to the baseline. And yes!
She's got
the lead. They want Turner. Can't get that one to fall. She He wins it back. Here's Johnson coming off the bench for the three. On the line for UConn tonight. Here's Allen. And this batted to Turner is there to clean it up, but can't hit. And another whistle. A lot of fouls here in the first half.
Do you see what
Associated Press All-America team, and since the first at the PA.
Wow, Warriors-Clippers, could that be a preview of the Western Conference Finals?
At midcourt, with a minute 48 to go here in the second. All-time, they are 34-11 against Notre Dame. Samuelson wants it. Nothing falling right now. Williams back out and tipped out of play by Mabry.
Nice second jumper.
Now the freshman Dangerfield. It could be very, very explosive. Williams again. Lost the dribble. Out of play off Notre Dame. Barnes plays about 21 minutes a game. Sanderson blocked out of the sky. That was Young. John goes down for it. Another tie-up. It'll stay on this end on the possession arrow.
It was up nine when Nafisa Collier went out. And now they're down four and they get to within two.
And Sanderson for the bucket. Stolen away by Sanderson. Young right behind her, but she will lay it in.
Yeah, just great anticipation. You know that. Only a 2 second differential, but I believe that like this, maybe with an opportunity just for an offensive rebound, but keep the Irish from getting a good look when they get it back.
John with it. Williams looking inside, up in there. On the drive, can't get it to go. And a heave of the well short. That's how the first half comes to an end.
Going to give him spot minutes in the interior. Dangerfield has had an up and down start to the season, as you might expect a freshman to do.
Collier back in there to start the second half. And a nice move, quick step there for two. Williams looking inside, nothing there. Shot clock down to nine. Here's Dangerfield, way downtown. They barely nicked the iron. And now back to the speedy Allen. Young, deflected. Once again, it's Williams. She's had a terrific defensive game. Freshman with a nice balance feed. Nearly taken away by the Irish. Downstairs for Williams. Can't back it in. Collier again, and that one will spin out. Taken away and laid right back up and in by Williams. She's been relentless.
From an Irish team that we're accustomed to being very patterned.
Underneath, Samuelson will get two.
It's coming easy for Connecticut. That's a nice little strong side cut by Katie Lou. He comes at you with good size.
6'3". And back with a vengeance after she was forced to miss the national championship game because of injury in the spring. Ogumba Wally gets her own shot, sticks it.
And that's with size in her face and a hand in contest. Now this kid has just got all the swag in the world on the offensive end of the floor.
Averaging 18 coming in. Collier, you're talking about too easy. So Collier, Ogumba Wally again, that three-pointer got a good look. It comes out high. Back for Allen. Triple team. She'll drive it anyway. And lay it in.
Now she has not had
on a 5-7. Ogumba Wale. Nifty give for Allen for two.
How pretty.
UConn with three consecutive turnovers. The only another one there is Williams got it off to Samuelson, and she sticks it.
It's amazing to me the different levels of play you can get from both of these teams. And I know it's early, but I think our expectations for both of them is that they're going to play at a high level no matter what. Players in different roles trying to accept more responsibility. This is what you're going to get.
Jump shot didn't touch anything there from Bowley. on the run. Look at Williams beat everybody to the other end.
Got to tune in to LaChina's podcast.
UConn with Crystal Dangerfield in the game, little 5'5 freshman, is Williams, who's had the hot hand, knocking it two more. Off to an excellent start here tonight, and UConn leading at 25-14. It's their biggest lead. Turner with a touch, turns and fires and got it. Notre Dame 0-for-4 from three-point land. Here's Allen. Like she was listening to you.
Yeah, and just a
shot down to three. Jump shot airmail. And Tom Williams didn't touch a thing. Deering stole it away. Here's Young to knock it in. And a foul as well, right along the baseline.
Placed, and then you don't see it, but Allen completes the play.
Turner doubled up, gets it out for Young. She hits it. A three.
To my house with that.
Seven on the shot clock. There goes Butler. She gives it away to Chong and lays it in on a blocking foul as well at the line. And a three-point play. Nelson with the hook. Yes.
It's good to see a frustration.
7-0.
One matchup to watch. Gabby Williams is checking Arike Ogunbowale, who just touched the ball for the first time. Vastly improved numbers from a season ago. Better outside jump shot for her.
Boy, she's hitting 56% beyond the three-point line. And a quick strike inside for Turner.
And one of the reasons the Irish have been successful, we showed you 7-7 over the last 14. The Irish is one team in the country that can score to the level that Connecticut can score. You've got to be able to put a number up.
UConn number one without the trio of Stewart, Jefferson, and Tuck anymore. Here's Chong. Fires that one back. Samuelson's first three and on target.
They do it a little more by committee, and Collier's been terrific.
And a foul with 12 seconds on the shot clock. And that will send Williams to the line, where she makes 64%.
Oh, I'd rather have seen a play on, to be perfectly. The drive, defense is not in great position necessarily. And sometimes those can be play-ons to me.
Ogunbowale going one-on-one. Flips it up, but it's in and out. Boy, that was in the cylinder.
Oh, she's a big-time difficult check. There's not a phase of the game now, because she's out of that three-point shot there that she cannot score from.
The season started by going 5-for-5 beyond the three-point line in the opener, and that's up and in by Collier.
She comes from the offensive player or the defensive player. That's a major point of emphasis.
Notre Dame, four consecutive empty trips, and a quick strike down low for William. Looking for Collier again, going up against Turner. On the drive, Nurse out of the double team. Great ball movement. Here's Samuelson. Can't connect from three. Collier there to scoop that up, and she'll take the hit. Maybe 73% at the line and hits the first. Let's go to Holly.
Point guard, she just doesn't have the experience, so an early foul on Allen is a big deal.
Well, Marina Mabry is...
Here comes Allen now, already with 1,000 points in her outstanding career. Nice dish underneath for Westfeld, and she connects.
Lindsay Allen, as Muppet calls her, the soul of our team. You're talking about an experienced point guard who understands the system, understands who to get the ball to and when. Really good job getting into their tempo game and making decisions.
Notre Dame had missed five in a row. Here's Williams. Gave up the dribble, back for Chong. Shot clock down to 7. She finds a lane, flips it up. Rebound tip controlled, and it's Chong to come down with it. Here's Williams. Got it.
And best of Turner. I think she needs more repetition and more time after that shoulder surgery that kept her out for 4 months.
Westbell with a nice move underneath. Shot to make it to age. Williams again. She's had a hot hand here early. Here's 6 points. That was her first miss. Ogunbowale straight on. Got that one. Maybe that'll get her started.
Yeah.
Williams coming in at 10.7 rebounds a game. Get the feeling she can do more than that.
Creating finish to the quarter, right? The Irish got the crowd back involved.
Second left here in the third. Nails it. So it's good for Turner. Now back up top here.
Look at Kia Nurse. Kia Nurse just ready to give some assistance, get out and challenge. Nurse doing her job defensively. Look at that. Dropping in.
Allen trying to spin. Tough shot. Got it.
That's a big time.
Could be strong with the ball here to end this game.
Good job by Gabby Williams to make a quick switch again. Connecticut's communication with all of these switches so crucial.
Here's Young over the top. Nice pass. Ogunbowale with a second effort and draws the foul.
Is that going to be on Kari?
On that one. Maybe. Ogunbowale with an averaging 18.
And both of these teams are going to look so drastically good.
Samuelson wants to go hard, flipped it up there and draws the whistle. 82% at the line. Here's Holly.
It's been different for you, and she said, you know, they didn't need me to be the go-to player last year. Of course, they have Brianna.
Samuelson. Williams, who's had such an impressive night. Here's Dangerfield with a left hand and two.
I tell you, the kid, it's not been a vintage night. It's not been what she did against Baylor, but she's fearless regardless of the circumstance.
At 19 against Baylor.
This is a tough matchup with Ogunbowale on her posting up.
There's almost a steal. Great dish there. Turner will finish it.
Well, how good is Lindsay Allen? How about that for execution?
Outstanding. Yeah, off the inbound.
That's nice.
That would have been a really big make for the Huskies. Ogunbowale off the back of the iron. She's hitting 56% from the three-point line. Coming up on the six-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. Turner. West Bell wants to go one-on-one. Turner got to it and hit it.
Well, she's been...
And Dangerfield getting some very big minutes here at Notre Dame.
He's chosen to finish with her quite often.
Shot clock down to 13. Nurse in the corner.
Dangerous pass.
Collier working on Turner. What a move that was.
Yeah, she has just got it.
Minutes to play here in South Bend. Nurse, tough drive and draws another foul.